Welcome back. The County Residential Center is a collaboration between McKinney ISD and the Collin County Juvenile Justice Department. Their goal is to provide a quality education for students who are in pre-adjudicated or post-adjudicated situations. Their reasons for being at the CRC are not nearly as compelling as their transformations as they leave the CRC. We welcome science teacher Natasha Knapton and Principal Cynthia Morton to tell us more about the County Residential Center, or CRC. Well, great. Welcome on the show.
Hi. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm glad you're here. Ms. Morton, if you don't mind, we'll start with you. Tell us a little bit about how long you've been in the school district.
I've been in McKinney ISD. I was at McKinney North High School, go Bulldogs, for 2 years before taking on the post at CRC. And I'm also the principal at JJAEP and DAEP. So three different locations. But by far, I think working with the students at CRC is the most rewarding because they're the most at risk. Mm-hmm. So I've really started enjoying, really enjoy working with the at-risk population.
Wow. And did you work with at-risk students before getting into CRC, JAEP, and
yeah.
so forth?
Yes, I did. I worked in Fort Worth at a place called Casada Learning Center, which was an outreach of the Catholic Diocese of Fort Worth. And we worked with the Juvenile Probation Department in Tarrant County and with others, Fort Worth ISD. So we had a lot of students who were in at-risk situations, and for many of them, it was really their last chance. They really needed to get on track educationally in order to be successful and go on to whatever was after high school for them.
Okay. And so the students that are at the CRC are in a judge a situation where they're going to court or they are already in a court situation.
At some point they'll be going, absolutely, they'll be going to see the judge at some point. Every student out there will see the judge within 24 hours. And then again, if the judge determines that the student needs to be held and more information gathered, each student will then again see the judge within 14 days.
And they stay there until?
And they stay there. And I think probably the most heartfelt I feel for the students is especially during the holidays. The summertime, not so much for me, because I think it's it can be a good environment, believe it or not. I always tell people that CRC is actually the Cheers of detention centers. Everybody knows your name. Really and truly, you'd think being locked up 24/7 and wearing a really ugly looking orange jumpsuit, it's probably not the greatest of environments, but it's a really interesting environment because the students, as they stay there, they get to know their officers and the teachers on a level that they've never really associated with teachers. The other thing that helps make the students really, really successful is the fact that they have a good night's sleep every night. They have three meals a day. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And unfortunately, so many of our students don't have that. Yeah. I know it's, we live in McKinney and we're in many ways a very affluent mm-hmm. county. But having said that, we still have people of poverty in our areas that really struggle with that. So we get students who maybe smoke some marijuana and do other things, clouds their judgment, and after they have a chance to be in there, get all the cobwebs out and have a good, three good meals and a good night's rest, they're able to really perform very, very well.
That's great. And now, what do you have to do to on your free time to just get away from CRC, and what do you like to do in your...
Well, there is no free time. No, there is. I love to travel. Absolutely love to travel. Love to scuba dive. It's one of the most relaxing things in the world for me. And since I don't get to do that as often as I'd like, I read. Love to read.
That's terrific. Now, Ms. Knapton is one of your teachers, I understand. And this is your second year in McKinney. What do you teach?
I teach science.
And
now she says she teaches science. She teaches all science. So make sure they understand
exactly
what you're talking about.
Yeah, what does that mean when you say you teach science at CRC?
At CRC, we have a unique environment where our students are not able to leave a certain section. And so all the children can range from age 10 to 18, well, almost 18. And so within that section, I have to go in and try and teach 7th grade, 6th grade, 8th grade, you know, and then biology, chemistry, physics, IPC, astronomy, geology, anatomy and physiology, environmental systems, yeah, anatomy, physiology. So whatever the kids are taking, that's what I teach them.
Wow. Do you like that? The smorgasbord method?
Most definitely. It's a great challenge. It's fantastic.
That's awesome. Okay, and is this your second year teaching in general?
This is my third year teaching. Yes.
That's great. Where were you before that?
I was at Bland High School down in Merritt, Texas.
Awesome. Well, welcome. What do you do outside of the CRC?
Well, I'm a mother of three, and I'm also studying for my PhD. So I go to school, out of school, and then, you know, just raise the kids.
That's great. Well, and I also understand we need to congratulate you because you are Teacher of the Year at CRC.
Yes.
This year, right?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Congratulations. That's great. Well, we are so excited about the project that you brought for us to see. So we're going to turn right to that. And this is a video that you had a great deal involvement in orchestrating. You're in the video as well.
Yeah.
You're an actress in it. I'm going to go ahead and say that. And did all of the post production on the project.
Mm-hmm.
Did you film the project too?
I took all the pictures and edited the pictures, put it to the music, edited the video, and all of it.
That's amazing. Is there a name for it?
That was one of the hardest things to figure out. No, it ended up turning into just, you know, McKinney ISD, County Residential Center. We had votes going on, and the kids had put a whole bunch of effort into it. But there was no one way to describe it, almost, that I found it impossible.
Okay, well, then we'll let the audience decide, I guess. All right, let's take a look.
I had a heart then, but
That's terrific.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for sharing it with us. Tell us a little bit about what motivated you to start the photography. I mean, where you just started taking pictures and thought, you know, wow, I've got some things, neat things here to build a video, or did it start with the music, or?
It actually came from the Teacher of the Year at CRC, and I found out that you had to have a video for the dinner, and so I thought, okay, what kind of videos have they done before? And so, because we're not allowed to show the children or anything like that. And so I learned that it was just usually an interview, but at the other schools, you know, they would interview the other students. And so, you know, the other schools had a chance to show certain things that we had not yet been able to do. Mm-hmm. And so I just thought about how can I take the moment to try and let our students speak for us. And I took it to the kids and told them what my idea was, and next thing I know, it first started off with just a couple little sayings here and there, and it grew with every week that went by.
How much of that was concept and just theatrical versus we actually do sometimes write on our arms, and so this is the real life for us to communicate, you know, words on our body. Was there sort of a mix of the two?
Well, I have a habit of writing on my arm all the time. And so for me, it just seemed like a natural way to communicate, because that's how I communicate with myself. Uh-huh. And so the kids thought, you know, that would be a great way for me to show what they want to say to everyone about our program and what they've learned about society, and especially what they've learned about themselves.
Yeah.
So it started to develop, and I actually have very little creativity, and the kids are the ones who came up with the storyboard. They came up with, you know, well, we need someone who's going to be arrested, and we need this to happen. And so each pod I would go to, I'd be like, okay, this was what was just said. What do you guys think? And so the kids really helped develop, and the officers have been amazing too. They came up with some fantastic ideas, and the things they let us get away with that, you know, past couple of times we were interrupting class, and it was always, oh, let me do this and take another picture. Yeah. I ended up with well over 300 pictures of just things that the kids wanted to keep saying.
Yeah.
And then trying to go through those and put them into a sequence, that was very challenging.
And the music, the choice of music was
the choice of music, I let the kids give me a list of different artists. We tried to narrow into an idea of, you know, what exactly did we want the music to participate with, you know. And eventually it came down to this particular song.
Yeah. I think one of the greatest aspects of the whole project is the fact that students who have never felt like they had a voice before, they actually had a voice, whether it was through their knuckles, you know, what was written on their knuckles or their arms. And there were a couple of, all of them were, you know, pretty insightful as far as where they're coming from as a human being. And the two that always stick out to me is the young lady that has her hands over
Absolutely,
and says, don't
yeah.
judge. And the other one with the line across saying, this is not an exit.
Mm-hmm.
And that, it's really difficult. You know, people will ask us, well, what do you do out there? Aren't you scared of those kids? Mm-hmm. And they're kids like any other kids. And
Absolutely.
They've just made a mistake, or they may be just the one who got caught. There, you know, there are all kinds of stories, and some of them will absolutely break your heart. But mm-hmm. what we always try to remember and try to reinforce, because we have those frustrating days as well, is that we have no idea what that student has been through. We have no clue where they've come from or what they've been through. And so we want their time at CRC to be as much a respite, if you will, mm-hmm. and more so of a kind of getting yourself together. Mm-hmm. And the county is absolutely amazing to work with. I hear horror stories about districts and counties, and they're always at odds with each other. And it's just not the case in Collin County. And mm-hmm. so that's truly a blessing and an honor to be able to work out there with those students.
Sure. Forgive me, and if I'm overstepping any bounds from the district, I apologize. But I really was also touched personally just by the amount of statements of faith. Mm-hmm. You know, that there were students that were saying, God has gotten a hold of me. while I've been here, that I've had a connection, kind of like a Lieutenant Dan, you know, moment. You got to make your peace. And was that something that, I assume it wasn't something that you initiated, but students wanted to say something about their faith. Mm-hmm. And I think that's also remarkable, too, that there's, that they see something bigger than themselves. That alone, you know, communicates a concept of, you know, I can't continue to live a selfish life, you know, that's going to tear me down and then, you know, subsequently tear other people down, too. I was touched by that. The photography, you say not creative. Oh, my goodness, the photography is wonderful, and I understand you did a lot of the, or you did all the post-production. Mm-hmm. How did you do the post-production?
I did everything on the iPad. Took the pictures with the iPad and then just downloaded a couple different apps and used
and
the apps.
Were you able to show the students some of that in the process?
Oh, definitely.
And get feedback from them about, what do you think about how I sort of changed the color in this shot, or I added these, you know, speckles of what, I know nothing,
definitely,
obviously.
Definitely,
but
they were looking forward to almost every other day, because I had to cut it back, you know. They kept saying, oh, can we see what's going on so far? And my husband and I, we'd stay up, I think, about till 1 or 2 in the mornings at times.
Yeah.
Just trying to edit it and go through it and get the timing down right, and then that way I'd have something to bring in and show them. You have no idea how excited they are about this video actually getting online, and I mean, they feel like they're superstars at this point, and yeah, it's wonderful.
So now, you said a minute ago it'll air at the Teacher of the Year banquet, right? Mm-hmm. We'll get students and teachers and administrators will get to see it then.
Yes.
And then eventually it'll be online. We'll be able to see it, or is it already available?
Yeah, we're hoping to get it on YouTube so that, you know, others can see, you know, what it really is, what we really do. Mm-hmm. And you know, I'm just a very small part of it, but the teachers and the officers that are out there, you know, I don't care what your religious or spiritual affiliation is, there's a greater power at work out there than any of us. And you talk about the students finding that greater power, whatever it is for them. And I think it's a large part of that is by the example that our teachers and the officers out there demonstrate on a daily basis. And you know, a lot of them will be very honest with you and say, you know, why do you still like me? I was a jerk to you yesterday. I mean, I was a really big jerk to you.
Yeah.
And that's no different from any student anywhere in McKinney ISD or anywhere else. You know, kids are kids, and they're going to make mistakes.
Yeah.
My hope is that they make them when they're young. They figure out, you know, what to do better or what not to do, and, you know, learn from it and move on from it. But a lot of people just think they're bad kids. They're great kids who have some circumstances that are beyond anything I could have probably dealt with, yeah, at that young age. Mm-hmm. And some of them are just great kids from great families who just do something that's not real smart at the time.
Yeah.
So, you know, we get a little bit of everything.
Yeah, well, and the fact that they are young, then they're still in, you know, a jurisdiction that we can help them. And so it's so much more than teaching science.
Definitely.
Or math or history or English or whatever.
And it's things like that beyond the science, you know, I don't know if I could tell you one biology project I ever did. No offense to science teachers. But I can tell you, those young men and young ladies will always remember being a part of this video.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you so much for working on it and the idea, the brainchild. It's very creative. Again, thank you for being on the show. It was glad to have
Absolutely.
You again.
Thanks so much.
If you'll stick around, we're going to do a McKinney ISD famous look-alike here. Before we end the show, we need to take a quick minute to check out the latest McKinney ISD famous look-alike. This is our opportunity to see how closely someone in the district may resemble a famous person like me. No, not really. Just roll it. All right. Let's see. Haven Smith. Oh, and Mr. Arnold, assistant principal. I think he's at Cockrell Middle School now. I don't know if that's right. Because he was at Evans for a little bit. No, he's at, but he definitely looks like this guy from Stargate Atlantis. I was thinking when we said Stargate Atlantis, he was a looking guy, you know? But that's awesome. That's awesome. Incidentally, if you think you have a good candidate for the McKinney ISD Famous Lookalike segment, and by famous, we mean that they actually just, well, forget it, just that they slightly resemble any famous person at all, let us know at met@mckinneyisd.net. That's it for today's show. Thank you for joining us. And on the next episode of Studio In, we hope to check in with a student from Dow who spent some time this year as a youth governor, one of my students, actually. We'll see you next time in the studio. Studio M, your McKinney ISD talk show.